What's good for the goose is not up in gander.
Coral Ridge Ministries presents Learn to Discern with John Ray.
Those who want the government to take over health care in this country often point to the Canadian system as an example of how things should be. In America, the argument goes, greedy health care and insurance providers have conspired with drug companies to swindle the American people, while places like Canada, with heavy government controls, offer the same level of health care for much cheaper. But this narrative keeps smashing head-on into a thing called reality. Consider the case of Danny Williams. Williams is the premier of the Canadian province of Newfoundland and Labrador. Consider it roughly akin to being a state governor. Recently, he discovered he had a life-threatening heart ailment requiring specialized surgery. No problem for the vaunted Canadian government healthcare system, right? Wrong. Williams announced that he's having the surgery done in Miami, Florida. Said Williams, quote, "I have the utmost confidence in our own healthcare system in Newfoundland and Labrador, but we are just over 500,000 people. This is a very specialized piece of surgery that had to be done." Facing criticism back home, he added, quote, "I did not sign away my right to get the best possible health care for myself when I entered politics," unquote. Is it just possible that health care is more expensive here because it's better? Danny Williams voted with his feet. Remember that when someone comes along trying to take that option away from you.